Hey guys, it's Rob doing another video today, right now, on the current economy again. I'm going to keep talking about this almost every day as things progress. First thing I want to talk about today is applications for new homes are plummeting. What does this mean and why is it happening? So let's talk about the permit process, right? Because everyone's talking about there's low inventory. Markets like Los Angeles, New York, all these different markets are saying there's not enough homes for sale. And now, because the prices are starting to come down, sellers that want to get out before it may come down more are actually starting to list it. We're seeing a little bit more inventory pop up. And when we talk about inventory, we're talking about a key term that we use as professionals, which is called attrition rate. The attrition rate means what percentage of homes sell in a year period on average? So, for example, the average American neighborhood, which is whether it's in Florida, Ohio, Texas, the normal attrition rate for a neighborhood is 10%, which means out of 100 homes, if that neighborhood has 100 homes in that area, 10 of those homes within a 12-month period will sell on average. In Los Angeles, especially on the West Side, Beverly Hills, West Hollywood, high demand areas, they have a much lower attrition rate, usually around 3%. If I'm looking at Santa Monica, Marina Del Rey, Pacific Palisades, your attrition rate's 3%. So out of 100 homes, three are going to sell. So what does this mean? This means that on average, it's very hard to get a home in a low attrition rate neighborhood. And this means that there's low inventory, which usually pushes up buyer demand, meaning there's more buyers than there are sellers. Now, as the market starts to shift, as we talked about in my previous video, we look at days on market, which tells me, is it a seller's market, a neutral market, or a buyer's market? If it's a seller's market, things are selling quickly within 30 to 60 days. You can list your house for sale. You're going to get at least one offer, probably multiple offers if it's at a low attrition rate area. If the attrition rate goes up, means there's more supply in that given market. So if the attrition rate goes to 20% instead of 10%, it means now 20 homes out of 100 will sell within a year. What does that mean? It means a buyer has more options. More options means they can leverage their cash more. They can negotiate better deals. Sellers have to be more flexible if there's more competition. The basics of supply and demand economics. So when we look at supply, we're looking mainly at the attrition rate and on average, how many new homes are coming to the market. Because there's really only two ways to get supply. Either an existing property owner is going to sell, which is called a resell, or a new construction property is completed, or they're selling at pre-completion, and that is new inventory. Those are the two ways to get supply. In Los Angeles, the permit process takes a very long time, and it's different in each niche area. For example, Culver City, which is just east of the 405 or the 10 and the 495 in between there, they have a little faster permit process, but you're still looking at 18 months to 2 years to get an architect involved, an engineer, all the reports that you're going to need. You're going to need soil reports, engineering reports, plot maps. You may need to get the neighborhood approval. All that takes a lot of time. Then you give it to the city to look over everything, and they usually come back with corrections, and they usually do that three, four, five times. So by the time you actually get your permit, it may be 18 months later, 12 months later, 6 months probably at the quickest I've ever seen. So that's just when you can actually start construction. Now you have to build, and the city inspects it during that construction process. They construct it, you have to pour your foundation. They have to come out and check your rebarb and all your fittings before you can actually pour. Once that's poured, they have to come back. There's several times that the city gets involved during these inspections. You have to pass all inspections completely for the city to then give you, you know, a certificate of occupancy, meaning now someone can live in that property. And I've seen this process take 3-4 years. For an example, the worst areas would be the Mulholland Corridor, which would be a lot of the Beverly Hills, at the top of the hills. They call it the Mulholland Corridor. It means not only do you have to go through the city, sometimes even the county, but now you have a special subdivision that also has to approve it. Those approvals usually take minimum 2 years, sometimes 3 or 4. You also have the Coastal Commission in California. So anything pretty much left of Lincoln Boulevard in Venice and Santa Monica, you have to get approval from the Coastal Commission. So not only do you have to go through the city, the Coastal Commission has to sign off, and they have specific regulations as well. That's why to build in Venice Beach, you're looking at 2 years minimum to get your permits. So why are we seeing new home applications for permits starting to plummet? Well, I think you're looking at two key reasons. One, builders and homeowners that may have purchased a property or a plot of land to build their own house or an investment property are thinking that the market may go down further. So they don't want to invest right now, knowing that their completion isn't even going to be for at least 12 months, 18 months, depending on the area, maybe 2 or 3 years to finish that project. And they're thinking and looking ahead and saying, hey, if we spend today's prices in 2 years from now, the market's 20% or 30% lower, that's their entire profit margin right there. So you're seeing a lot of people looking at the market dynamics and kind of sitting back and waiting. That's one of the key reasons. The other reason is the cost of supplies since pre-pandemic levels has skyrocketed. The cost of wood, the cost of everything, nails, glue, hardwood flooring, pretty much every item that goes into a house, electrical wiring, has all drastically gone up. Lumber has gone down slightly since maybe 6 months ago, but it's still 5 to 10 times more expensive than it was in 2019. So now, not only are they concerned about what the market may do in terms of coming down in terms of value, they're also saying, hey, my expenses, it may cost me twice as much to build that home. So these factors are what new home constructors, investors are looking at. Now, if you're building your own home for your own benefit and you can afford it, you're probably going to go ahead. For example, if you have a couple million bucks in the bank and you bought a plot of land in the hills with beautiful views, you're not really worried about what the resale value is when it's completed. Now, I have some clients that are worried, but they still may go forward just because they'll live in it for a couple years, hope the market comes back in 5 to 10 years, and then they'll be okay. But the investors are what bring new inventory to the market. What does new inventory do? It allows more buyers to get in. So when we're talking about a shortage on housing, we're talking about a shortage on new housing or resale housing. Now, resale is okay, but someone's still going to need to live in that property. They'll move to a new property or a new area. So when we're talking about expanding housing, especially in dense areas like LA, you have to look at new construction. Now, they have allowed accessory dwelling units. So now you can convert a single family home lot, if it's big enough, and build a secondary smaller unit on there and actually rent that out or use it as an in-law suite or for another family member. We are seeing a lot of those because even though the price of construction has gone up, the permit process is expedited. So instead of waiting 18 months, you can usually get those permits between 6 to 9 months and have the whole thing completed within 12 to 18 months. But it can only be about 50% of the size of the original house, and there's also some restrictions. But we're seeing Florida also enact that. So Florida is not as densely populated in a lot of areas as California, but in the major cities, now you have the option of building an accessory dwelling unit. And some of Florida aren't as strict, so you could even Airbnb that secondary unit, and that secondary unit may cost you 120 or 150 to build, but if you're now making 2 or 3,000 a month off of it, you can finance that and it still makes a lot of sense. But we're seeing permits drop for new construction homes. And this usually is a great indicator because these investors are smart, they're savvy, right? They have to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars, and then really they're only making a 20, 25%, maybe 30% profit margin. So they're investing 2, 3 years of work in hopes of making a 20% profit margin on, let's say, $1 million that it costs to build that property. Now, most of the time they can then finance 90% or 100% of that construction cost after the builder has purchased that property. So interest rates are also affecting it. So they're getting hit by supply, cost of materials are much higher, financing costs is much higher for them to finance the construction cost, and now there's uncertainty in the market. So as long as those three factors are in play, we're going to see new constructions drop. In China, they overbuilt. So not only do they not need new supply of condos, they're knocking down and demolishing condos that they overbuilt. So these are big indicators and red flags that we look for. Now, what does this mean if you're buying a home? It means you may want to sit back and wait unless you find a good deal. Remember, I talked in my last video about specific deals. If you can find a buyer or a seller that is in need and has to sell their property, they will negotiate where you can pad in maybe a 5 or 10% below market offer that they may accept because the seller may say, hey, if I wait any longer, it's going to come down 5 or 10% anyway. And you, as the buyer, can say, hey, even if it drops another 5 or 10%, I'm getting that off of today's value, so I'm covered. Now, in a market like Los Angeles, that makes sense because even in 2008, we really saw prices drop at most 25 to 30% in some areas. But in Las Vegas, we saw prices drop 50 or 60%. So if you're buying in Las Vegas and the market drops 40% and you just purchased a deal today and got 10% off, you may be in trouble. And what we know from cyclical history, and in my book, I wrote about the cycles. They're usually 7 to 10 year economic cycles. So it takes, if the market corrects, you're going to have to wait 7 to 10 years in order to get back to where you're buying it at today. And we saw this in 2008, right? If you bought a home in 2008 or 2009, it really took until 2016, 17, 18, 19 for you to equal that same price value, depending on which area you're in. So these are all things to consider. If you're a seller today, look at the attrition rate in your neighborhood and the average days on market. Every neighborhood is different. So your neighborhood may be in great shape. There's still neighborhoods that are not seeing dramatic effects. For example, Mar Vista in Los Angeles, which is just east of Venice Beach, they're doing pretty well. They have a little bit more inventory, but it's still so slim. There's only 5 or 6 homes really in this specific area that people are looking for that has a good school system, that places are still selling pretty quickly and they can still command a good price. But if you look at another area like Inglewood, that's just 15 minutes away, now you see the attrition rate, more resale buyers putting their homes on the market, which means prices are likely going to come down because there's more sellers than there are buyers. So look at those key indicators and look at your specific neighborhood. Now, if you don't know how to do a market analysis, call up your local realtor. Almost all of them should offer that at no cost to let you know exactly what's going on in your neighborhood. They'll look at the active listings, what's sold within the last 3 to 6 months, and also what's been canceled or expired, meaning they put it on the market and they didn't get the price they want, and the listing expired and is no longer on the market. They took it off, but that seller still owns it. So those are some key factors to look at. We're going to keep looking at how this economic situation pans out, especially as we go into the winter months. And it may be some buying opportunities as an investor to pick up some good deals depending on your area. We don't know where things are going to be a year from now. So again, the Fed controls a lot of the macro market. We're going to have to see how they play out. If the federal government does more stimulus, that will affect things as well. Are they going to offer more incentives? Obama offered an $8,000 buyer's credit in 2009, 2010, and 11 to get more people into the market that may not be able to afford the down payment. These are all things that could happen that will affect it. But right now, we're seeing those applications for new permits plummeting. We're seeing applications for new mortgages plummeting. And this tells me that investors and buyers are basically pumping the brakes and saying, hey, we need to wait and see what happens. Prices of goods are too expensive. Prices of materials are through the roof, and we don't know where the market's heading with the interest rates. So if you're a new investor or you're looking to build a property, it may make sense in your specific area. For example, we're doing a project in Joshua Tree. Even with higher costs, it still makes sense on paper because we're likely going to be able to short-term rent it. And some areas don't allow short-term rentals, so you have to look at what's going on in your area. These are things to keep in mind. We have to continue to look at these key indicators that are red flags of what's going on in the market, and then we can adjust as things go along. The market shifts slower in real estate, right? Because appraisals look 6 months back. So even though right now, today, it's the end of August, an appraiser is going to be looking at places that sold May, April, June, and looking and seeing what those prices were. So it's going to take several months to really see the effect as prices come down, as sellers adjust today, and then appraisals will come down. And then that's kind of a, you know, it's a spiral effect. So then it keeps getting lower and lower until things kind of even out. So keep in mind, it's not like the stock market where things can fall within one afternoon. In real estate, it takes several weeks and months to really feel the effect. So be patient, look for a great deal. Don't be scared if you're renting right now. Buying may make sense if it's going to make sense on paper and you're going to be saving more money than renting, but be cautious. That's my number one piece of advice. Be cautious, get a great realtor that can help hold your hand, because most of the time that advice is going to be really valuable in your decision, and there's no cost to it until you actually want to list the home with a realtor or pay for some of their additional services, which are usually included, especially as a buyer. Most realtors are completely free to you if you're buying a home that's already listed for sale on the MLS, the seller's paying that commission. So pick their brains, call your local expert, pick their brains, go on our website, look at what's active on the market, and you could start seeing, are places reducing their price? To me, that's the very first indicator. All these things are leading indicators, and then the lag indicator is, are listings reducing their price? So they're sitting longer, and they need to reduce their price to attract more buyers. If you want to learn more, we have a lot of educational programs at education.wearerealty.com. If you're an agent and want to join our referral network, we're looking for partners all across the world. You can do that at wearerealty.com/join. Or if you're in California, Florida, or Virginia, we'd love to have you as part of our brokerage. Reach out, and I'd love to mentor you on how to grow your business as well.